Now we can see some questions. First question reads as, which of the following statements is not correct about a nucleophile? There are four choices given. First choice reads as, nucleophile is a Lewis acid. Second choice, nucleophiles are electron seeking species. Third choice, ammonia is a nucleophile. Fourth choice, nucleophilic attack takes place at low electron density sites. It is given. So nucleophile means species attracted by nucleus. Nucleus is originally positively charged. Only negatively charged species will be attracted by nucleus. Negatively charged species means it is a Lewis base. So Lewis bases are electron donating or negatively charged species. So first statement itself is not correct. That is, nucleophile is a Lewis base. The statement that nucleophile is Lewis acid is not correct. However, let us check all other possibilities. Nucleophiles are electron seeking species. Electron is negative charged, nucleus is positively charged, they will seek one another. Ammonia has unpaired electron, so it will, ammonia has unpaired electron, so it is a nucleophile. Ammonia is a nucleophile. Nucleophilic attack takes place only at low electron density size, that is positively charged species, low electron density. First, second, third and fourth statements are correct. First statement is wrong. So first statement is not correct about. So the correct statement about nucleophile is that nucleophile is a Lewis base. Now the second question reads, some deactivating groups are given. Cyano group, carboxyl group, nitro group and sulfonic acid group. Cyano group CN, carboxyl groups COOH and NO2 nitro group, sulfonic acid groups are given. These are called meta directing groups. What is mean by meta directing groups? So you have one mono substituted compound. In a mono substituted compound, for example, let us take the case of benzene benzoic acid. So benzoic acid, on further substitution, the next substituent goes to the meta position only. So that is mean by meta direct. So for example, if you have phenyl cyanide, next substitution goes to the only meta. So if there are carbon atoms are separated by one carbon atom, that is called meta directing group. Similarly, nitro group directs further substituent only in the meta position. Sulfonic acid group, SO3H group directs. All these are meta directing groups. But some of them activate the benzene ring, others do not activate. What is meant by activation? Only if it activates, the second substituted compound will be available. Otherwise, it is not possible. So the compound species which does not activate, or in other words which deactivates, it will not produce the second substituent to enter itself, which is that compound. So the question is, in aromatic substitution, most deactivating meta directing group, in aromatic substitution, the most deactivating meta directing group among these is dash. All are electron withdrawing, all are minus A effect groups, electron withdrawing group, cyano group, this carboxyl group, nitro group, this comes under the category of electronic displacements. So all are electron withdrawing group, but electron withdrawing capacity is maximum with nitro group. So nitro group highly deactivates. So nitrobenzene cannot be further nitrated. So metadenitrator, even in the, we will see the compound, if you have nitrobenzene, so nitrobenzene, if it is further nitrated, metadinitrobenzene will be formed, but condition is very rigorous, high temperature, presence of catalyst, only it is forced. So But benzene can be easily converted to nitrobenzene. So benzene can be converted to nitrobenzene. After conversion, it will not allow other nitro group even in the metaposition. So the most deactive, but carboxylic acids are possible. Benzene carboxylic acid, tallic acid, phenylene dicyanate, sulfonic acid are possible. But the most deactivating group is nitro group. Among this, aromatic substitution, all these are aromatic benzene derivatives. So for this question, the answer is, in aromatic substitution, the most deactivating metadirecting groups among cyano, carboxylic, nitro and sulfonic acid is nitro group. So this is the correct choice for the current question. Third question reads, it is based on the presence of electrons, pi electrons and p orbitals. So the question reads in this fashion. C6H5CH2. This radical is called benzyl radical. Benzene, benzyl. So dot means unpaired electron. So benzyl radical is aromatic. It is given in this form. It is not given in this form. It is given in this form. It can be easily studied as aromatic. But it is, it may be even straight chain. 6-7 carbon system. Straight chain compound also with the there. So benzyl radical here, this radical C6H5CH2 radical is aromatic because it has dash number of p orbitals and dash number of unpaired electrons. Now since it is benzyl radical, we have to write in this fashion: alternate double bonds and CH2 dot. So 1, 2, 3. 3 pi bonds are there. Each bond consists of 2 electrons. 6 pi electrons are there. So, different choices are given. 6, 6, 9, 6, 6, 9, 9, 9, like that. So, we have to identify the correct choice. Now, number of carbon atoms, even though 7, only 6 carbon atoms are involved in the resonance. So radical, that is why it is containing, they are in the ring. 6 carbon atoms are in the ring, 7th carbon atom is outside the ring. So they are involved in sp and sp2 hybridization. So it contains 6 p orbitals. So it has 6 p orbitals and 6 unpaired electrons, that is why it is aromatic. Now we have to note that the condition for aromaticity. So, what is the condition for aromaticity? For a compound to be aromatic, number of pi electrons, you have to remember this is 4n plus 2. So, number of pi electrons is 4n plus 2, where n is the number of rings inside a compound. Number of rings inside a compound. This has to be noted. This is called Huckel's rule of aromaticity. H-U-C-K-E-L, Huckel's rule for aromaticity. This Huckel's rule of aromaticity states that number of pi electrons is 4n plus 2 if n is the number of ring. For example, we can check for just benzene and naphthalene. So for this it is aromatic. Anyhow, this rule has to be remembered. So benzene and naphthalene. Naphthalene, we have two benzene rings. So, ultimate structure is in this fashion. 5 sigma bonds are there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 sigma bonds. 5 into 2, 10 electrons or 10 pi electrons are there. So, it has 2 rings. So, 4 into 2 plus 2. 4, 2, sorry, 8 plus 2, 10 pi electrons. Similarly, anthracene, it will contain 14 pi electrons. Anthracene, phenanthrene, they will contain 14 pi electrons. So, in the case of heterocyclic compounds, it has to be remembered also the electrons of heteroatoms such as nitrogen, oxygen. That is why pyridine is aromatic, pyrrole is aromatic. So, the nature of aromatic compound for pyridine, pyrrole has to be explained taking into account the lone pair of electrons of heteroatoms such as nitrogen, oxygen, sulfur. This finishes the current question. Now, this question reads as the ionization of carbon-chlorine linkage yields most stable carbonium ion. Which of the following species? All species contain carbon-chlorine linkage, CCl, CCl, CCl. Which of the following compounds, CCl, in which of the following compounds, CCl covalent bond ionization results in the formation of most stable carbonium ion. So, if you have CCl linkage, chlorine is more electronegative than carbon. So, both the sigma electrons will move towards chlorine, whereby carbon becomes positively charged and chlorine becomes negatively charged. In every case, there is a formation of positively charged carbon atom is called carbonium ion. So, in every case, carbonium ion is possible. This compound is called tertiary butyl chloride. There are four carbon atoms, butyl. So, one and the same carbon atom bears all the alkyl groups. It is called tertiary butyl chloride. This one, isobutyl chloride, isopropyl chloride. There are three carbon atoms. Isopropyl chloride. This one, BENZYN, benzyl chloride. This one, 1-nitro-2-chloro-ethane, IUPAC name, 1-nitro-2-chloro-ethane. Every compound has CCl linkage. So, CCl, chlorine is more electronegative than carbon. It will shift towards carbon. Everywhere, carbonium ion will be formed. C plus, C plus. So, that only that carbon which bears chlorine. So, C plus and C plus. So, all will yield carbonium ion. But which will be most stable? This is primary carbonium ion or 1 degree carbonium ion. So, RCH2 grouping is called primary carbonium ion. R2CH grouping, this is secondary carbonium ion. Primary carbonium ion is denoted as 1 degree. Secondary carbonium ion, this one R3C plus. Tertiary carbonium ion or tertiary carbon. This one, this is also primary carbonium ion because CH2Cl. So, we have two primary carbonium ions, one secondary carbonium ion and tertiary carbonium. Tertiary carbonium ion is the most stable. If you compare the stability of carbonium ions, tertiary carbonium ion is most stable. Then comes secondary carbonium ion. Least stable is primary carbonium. So, the most stable is tertiary carbonium ion. So, tertiary butyl chloride is the most stable carbonium ion. First choice is the correct choice for this question. So, this compares the stabilities of carbonium ion. We have to bear in mind that for the stability of carbonium ion, this statement has to be borne in mind. Tertiary carbonium ion is more stable than secondary carbonium ion, which in turn is more stable than primary carbonium ion. That is to be noted. Now, this question reads as follows. That is, the enolic form of ethyl acetoacetate. This is the structure of enolic form of ethyl acetoacetate. They have given the keto form as well as enol form in the question. Has dash sigma bonds and dash pi bonds. Four choices are given. 9-1, 18-2, 9-2 and 16-1. So, let us completely exhaustively write the structure and identify the number of sigma bonds and pi bonds. Here C double bond C is en, OH is all. So, it is a enol isomer. CH3, so it is CH3, COH, double bond and CH, then C double bond as well as single bond, COO, and then C2H5 can be written as CH2 and CH3. So, to exhaustive representation of the combo, that is CH3. Now, this combo, how many double bonds are there? CC double bond and CO double bond. Only double bonds will contain pi bonds. So, there are two pi bonds, one and two, two pi bonds. Now, let us calculate. So, two pi bonds are there in the combo. Now, number of sigma bonds, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. Now, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17 and 18 sigma bonds. So, the system contains 18 sigma bonds and 2 pi bonds. So, if we erratically measure, it may end up with some other choices, 1, 9, 1. So, if we miss C double bond O in the ester linkage is missed, it will lead to 1 like that. So, it has to be carefully identified. So, the correct choice for this question is the enolic form of ethyl acetoacetate with the structure CH3COH double bond CH COOC2H5 has 18 sigma bonds and 2 pi bonds. So, this finishes the questions.